Time to start hunting then. Read the details on your device to see which species I am suggesting. This is a good way for you to study the species that are only present in South Asia. I am now close to the village, but I have not seen the tiger yet.
Good job. You're a quick learner, especially hunting in a part of the world you're not familiar with. Let's maybe hunt one more.
Bad news. The tiger is back. It is near the village. I am almost there.
Please go back to the village as soon as possible. Stay safe, both of you. Did I hear a gunshot on your end?
Can you hear me, Suraj? He is a neighbor. He is bleeding. But he is speaking with me. The tiger was already on him when I arrived. If I had not taken that shot right away, he would have died.
We're lucky that you were able to react so quickly. Good work.
I need to take care of him now. Can you take care of the tiger? Follow the blood trail and find the corpse of the tiger.
Corpse. Are you sure she's dead?
Yes, I am sure. I had a good line of shot and I landed a good shot. The man-eater will not suffer.
A man-eater. I hope Suraj's injuries aren't too serious, in case she's not dead. Once you find the corpse, I hope we can find clues as to what drove that tiger to become a man-eater. Why did she get so comfortable? Or desperate? Earlier, Nepal's put a lot of effort into its wildlife conservation strategy in the last 30 years, and you could say we've been rather successful. However, it also means that there are more tigers competing for the same territory and prey. We've closely monitored the populations and their roaming areas, and we're making sure to give them enough space on the reserve and corridors that they can safely use. But recently, there have been more conflicts with the villages located on the reserve grounds. That's what Birendra was referring to. Nepal has had a few man-eaters that made the national headlines in the last few years, and no one wants that. You found the tiger dead. Birendra's a good shot. Inspect the corpse and let us know if you notice anything out of the ordinary. Something wrong with its canine teeth. Damaged, you said. Could you please send me a photo? Thanks. Look, you can see that only two canines are damaged. Really sharp damage, too. That usually doesn't happen to tigers out in the wild. That's also not from today, since Birendra only shot once, and in the heart. If you ask me, that's the work of poachers. We've suspected their presence in the region lately, but we weren't sure. So we have our answer. Because its canine teeth were badly damaged, the tiger couldn't catch its usual prey. because our hides are too thick. So it had to turn to easier targets and softer hides just to be able to eat livestock and humans. Ultimately, we did this. Birendradai, have you heard? We found the tiger had had its teeth shot before, probably by poachers.
Poachers, huh? That is really a shame. But maybe there is not much we can do, Asmita. Maybe we should show our friend what reality is here. There is a flip side to Nepal's successful conservation.
So, do you know anything about any poachers, Dai? Who they might be?
No, nothing. Sorry, I cannot help. I've reached the water buffalo grounds. Then let me tell you a bit about their story here. Wild water buffaloes have been reintroduced to the area, and they started interbreeding with our domestic water buffalo. Now, the government does not know how to classify them or how to deal with them. So we are stuck until paper pushers make their decision, and our own domestic buffalo can't graze. This is why we need expert hunters as part of our staff. There's always some population control to be done.
Can you take care of some of the wild water buffalo for us?
It's not just in Tarai, you know. You'll see similar issues in all regions. Right, Asmita?
Things are not perfect, of course. We also have issues with Nilgai in the Pahad. Go back to the Pahad, near the spot I'm sending you on your hunter mid. It's good that you get an overview of the various issues we're dealing with.
The other day I had an argument with Manish, the young farmhand that works with me. He was desperate to find a poacher to help him make more money. I told him it was a bad idea, and he agreed. But I kind of understand him.
I know. People, when they can't put food on the table, or when they lose livestock, they get desperate. But poaching is not the solution. All it does is turn people against wildlife. Locals against the reserve. And at the end of the day, it harms everyone. Us and the animals.
You have arrived at the Nilgai feeding grounds. You know, for us farmers, Nilgai are simply pests. They love feeding very close to our farms. But ever since the reserve has been established, farmers aren't allowed to clear them out anymore.
Hunting is illegal out here. Unless you're a foreign tourist and bought an expensive license, or if you're a warden with a special license. So their populations are out of control. They have no natural predators, and they ruin our pastures for our own livestock.
The only thing we can do is have our wardens do some culling. But we're only a handful for such a massive territory. So we could use your help on that as well. Could you cull some Nilgai? At the end of the day, the world counts how many Bengal tigers or snow leopards are alive in Nepal. But they don't count the number of cattle lost to wildlife, or even human lives. They don't count how much money we lose.
The reserve. They're doing what they can to balance it out, but the bureaucracy is just too slow.
Sorry, Asmita, but you know everyone is waiting for compensation for loss of income from the higher-ups. Kya karne?
I know. What's to be done? I can only agree with you on that. We're just doing the best we can. But I disagree we should just give up. Birendra Dai, you told me things were even worse before the region became a reserve. It's not as bad as you presented. We've made great progress, and I want our friend here to see the good things as well.
Anyway, I think you understand our situation better now. Sometimes the decisions are made by people living in cities, and they never have set foot out here, or seen our farms, or the wildlife. We, the Tharu people, know best what to do about finding balance with wildlife here in Tarai. And there are lots of cultures in the Pahar who are experts in their own areas. Gurung, like Asmita, the Rai people, the Limbu. They solve problems from their offices, but here in rural areas, we're not their priority. That's the reality.